Good afternoon. We've now been back in school in person with some students since September. The youngest students have been in school 4 days a week. The older elementary students and middle school students have been on that alternating blended schedule, except for those that chose to remain in the Home Learning Academy since late in the fall. And at the beginning of the second semester, we brought back high school students in the blended model, again, with the additional option of the HLA. And over the last few days, and maybe the last 2 weeks, there have been a number of conversations across the state about what the next step is and when we would bring more students back. There's legislation that just passed the General Assembly that is now on the governor's desk that mandates a full return for any student that wants it next fall to in-person learning for a minimum of 990 instructional hours as it's always been. And we have also received new research information. A day after the last board meeting where I joked with a board member about the percentage, you know, the chance, the likelihood of students returning 5 days a week at the beginning of next school year, I was in a statewide superintendent's meeting where physicians from the American Academy of Pediatrics presented research data on the effect of universal masking, research data related to effects on children, as a result of the pandemic and isolation, and then also research as it relates to transmission in schools. So there have been a number of school divisions. Back in December, the number was about 8 or 9 that have operated at 3-foot distancing, which is the international rule from the World Health Organization, and also a recommendation by the American Academy of Pediatrics. And from those school divisions, we've now learned a lot. There are now 25 school divisions that are operating at 3 feet with all students back at least 4 days a week. And so there's important information that I need to share. I need to share that information with the school board. I need to share that information with you and with the public. But it's good to share that information at one time rather than letting little pieces trickle out. I know over the last few days, there have been a number of conversations about whether Rockingham will bring more students back. Page County made an announcement last night. I know tonight there's a school board meeting in Augusta County. And again, we have our school board meeting on Monday. And so what I can tell you is no decision has been made, right? All these decisions are made in consultation with the school board. As part of this message, there's a survey that we ask you to complete asking about your thoughts on bringing students back, what concerns you have, also what timing seems reasonable. And so we want to take your input as well. And once we have that, again, on Monday, I will update the school board. Now, what I will say is we have learned that there is very little difference between school divisions that operate at 3 feet and those that operate at 6 feet, but there is an enormous difference in the effect of masks. And so school divisions that have done this well and have brought more students back, really most of their students or all their students, have had to really focus on these mitigation strategies that we've talked about for a while. Universal masking and making sure that we also distance whenever possible, right? But masks are the key mitigation strategies. Increased ventilation, you know, Dr. Fauci told us that back in October. Distance will become less important, but masking and ventilation will become key. And we've taken all those steps. And so it's natural that we have that conversation now, and you need to be in the loop on this, right? So I want you to know that we're having the conversation. I want you to know that collection of research information will be presented, also what the recommendations remain to be from the CDC and what VDH is working on, what DOE is saying. And so give us until Monday to get all that information in a useful format and present that. And then I will have that conversation with the school board. And again, the survey that's attached to this email is your chance to provide feedback as well. So please do that. And then you will hear more from us as we have further conversation next week. But again, no decisions have been finalized, and you certainly deserve to have your chance to provide that feedback as well. So please take advantage of it and have a great weekend. Thank you.